BitSwap is the hottest new way to trade tokens. Crawling all the top decentralized exchanges, BitSwap gets you the very best price and value for your trades. BitSwap is changing the game. Try it now at bitswapdex.io. I didn't think it was right if I just came on this video tonight and did another scripted video. I really wanted to talk to you guys from the heart today because I know what a lot of you guys are going through and it's tough. What happened this morning with the Bitcoin price was very bad. Now, not very bad for the long term, but it was very bad for a lot of you guys. I know myself, I got liquidated not once, but twice. And I know a lot of you guys have gone through the same thing. And so I wanted to take this time to really talk to you about what happened this morning and about where you guys can go from here. So this dump, I'm not going to say it was unexpected, because what happened is we saw the Bitcoin price climb above 50,000. And if you watch this video or this channel, a lot of times we talked about how the price was heading upwards to $54,000. Well, once we got to 54K, we were expecting a drop. But then something happened. The price just kept climbing. It seemed like it was going to climb forever. When we got close to $60,000 at about 58,500, we know F2 pool sold, I think, 3,000 Bitcoin in 1 hour, and that started the unraveling and a lot of people taking profits. But this dump, it wasn't necessarily on the chart from what I could see. Everything seemed like it was still bullish, but the problem with that is, logically, if we think to the fact that we thought 54K was going to be a place to take profits, then at some point it had to go down. But really what I want to talk to you about is the emotions that you may be going through, because I know for a lot of you guys that this might be the first time you've experienced a pullback like this. And I mean, if we're going to be honest about it, we've never seen a pullback like this in the history of Bitcoin. We have seen 18% drops in one day before, but the numbers have never been this high. And I remember going back to the bear market. I talked a lot on this channel about, if you can't handle the swings during the bear market, just, or at least when the price had started to slowly go up and we were between $6,000 and $8,000, just wait until the price is at $80,000 and it drops to $50,000. I think I said those exact words on a video before. Well, now we were basically at $60,000. We dropped to $48,000 in one day, 18% drop. And that can bring a lot of really tough emotions for you guys that are trading, and then other ones, you know, other emotions for you guys that are doing more like, you know, altcoin investing or things like that. You really see the dramatic effect that the price of Bitcoin has on the market. When it drops considerably, altcoins, including Ethereum, get absolutely crushed. That's why I don't really trade Ethereum. I only invest in it. But something to think about is that you might be going through depression or sadness or anger, but that's all part of the market. It's all market psychology. You have to understand what charting is, what candlesticks represent. They don't represent price action per se. Like, yes, they have an open and a close and a top and a low. They have wicks and bodies. But the thing is they really represent human psychology. The way that a human reacts when the price hits a certain point. Now, that's why we get these lines of, you know, resistance and support, because there are certain levels where people say, like, okay, right here, when it gets up here, I probably should sell because it goes down often. And then, of course, the opposite for support. When the price drops to a certain point, people say, okay, from here, it looks like it will go up. And we've tracked human psychology for so long that we generally know the way humans are going to behave. Now, there are elements of market manipulation. We certainly know this. We've seen it with Wall Street bets and, you know, Wall Street in general, the traditional markets, centralized finance. But with DeFi and with Bitcoin, there isn't as much market manipulation, but it does certainly exist. The thing to keep in mind is the Bitcoin market cap at $1 trillion, it's not even as big as Apple or, you know, some other large companies. And I think that when it comes to remembering the crypto markets, especially with altcoins and Ethereum specifically, the market cap is not very large. When you have people investing on leverage, you have to understand it's not a $1 to $1 ratio between the market cap and what's actually invested into those. A lot of it is IOUs. So when you have somebody that comes in and dumps a huge amount, like 3,000 Bitcoin in the Bitcoin market, that's a pretty considerable amount of money, especially if that's on leverage as well. So there is market manipulation, but the psychology is when the prices go up dramatically at some level, people are going to think to themselves, hey, you know what? I think it's a good time right now if I take out some profits just to be safe. Let me pull out my original investment and then let the rest ride. We see that a lot. A lot of people talk about strong hands in crypto. It's important to remember that that's very easy when everything's going up. Everyone talks about strong hands when the prices are going up. But in reality, it's a very hard thing to do when the prices are going down because there's not a safety net. There's no safety net with crypto. We believe prices will never go to zero. And obviously, I wouldn't be doing this if I thought that they would. But there's no line to where we say no one would ever sell below this price. Can always be made an argument for everything. And the interesting thing is, and I'll tell you what I saw all throughout the bear market, was so many people said things like, man, if Ethereum got under $200, I would sell my house and put the money in. Well, what happens is once it actually gets down to that level, people are then scared and they don't do that. I'm telling you, I know so many people and I have so many friends that said, when this coin gets to this price, I'm going to go all in. But then it gets there and they're very, very scared. And you have to remember also the difference between trading and investing. So for you guys that are trading on Bybit like we are, you know, we talked about this morning on the stream, I got liquidated twice today. I'm trading. Now, of course, we made a lot more than that in the account, so it's not that big of a deal. I mean, it's a big loss, but we're way in the green, you know, with Bybit. The thing is, though, the trading is much more emotional than investing. If you look at cryptocurrency like investments and you just say, I have this amount of money, I'm going to put it in, I'm going to let it ride, then you're probably not going to have nearly as strong of emotions. You might look at, you know, your portfolio dropping, but it doesn't really matter because you know you're going to hold on to it no matter what, or at least throughout this bull market, and we don't think it's over. But for those of you that are trading, it's much more emotional. Now, If you do want to trade and you haven't ever traded before, you can do that on Bybit. You can go to bitboycrypto.com/deals and check it out. And a lot of you guys are listening to what I'm saying. When I'm telling you, trading is emotional. It can be dangerous. If you're not careful, you can get wrecked. You could lose your money. That's a thing that happens in a speculative market. But I think the takeaway from all this, from this entire video, is for you to get this point. The reason why we can make money with cryptocurrency is because of the volatility. When we have these dramatic dips, we can be very confident in a bull market, at least, that they're going to go back up. Now, one day there will be a dip. There will be the bear market dip and it won't come back up. We don't think that will be until much later this year. But you're not to look at this as something that's going to go up forever. When you do that, you take the wrong perspective. You have to be able to realize easy come, easy go. You got to lock in profits. And the people that locked in profits kind of started this, you know, the price dropping. You know, there's something to be said about that smart. We don't want everybody to go dump at the same time, of course. But taking profits is a good thing. Just remember this. The prices will not go up forever. You have to realize that you can dollar cost average out. You can take a certain amount out every day or every week or every month to make sure that you are locking profits and setting them to the side, because none of us know where the top of the market is. We don't know the exact top. No one's going to be able to call the exact top other than just by random luck. So the volatility is something that we like, and you can't be mad at it when it goes against your trade. You can look for dips, but those of you guys that get too over emotional, too angry, too sad, too depressed, I encourage you guys to talk to somebody about that. For sure, I see a counselor every few weeks. Obviously, we've had a lot of changes going on here, and I'm dealing with a lot of stuff, and it's something I would suggest for you guys to do too. Nothing's wrong in my life, but just to have somebody to talk to, somebody that can be a listening ear, and for you guys, it may just be a friend or a family member, but I don't ever want you to see anybody that's in the BitSquad get to a point where you get so sad that you make bad decisions. Just remember, trading is all about human psychology, and when you start feeling down, then that's a good sign usually that the prices could be moving up soon. They count on you to feel down and sell. So just wanted to have that heart-to-heart talk with you guys because I know a lot of you are dealing with a lot of stuff because of what happened this morning, the biggest dump in Bitcoin's history. And so I hope I can just be a little, you know, encouraging to you guys to know that we don't believe the market's over. We believe it will bounce back. Maybe even by the time this video posts, it will bounce back pretty hard, but it couldn't drop as low as 40K. I don't think it'll go lower than that, but that could be a bottom if this is truly the giant correction that we're going to get from that huge upswing we just saw. But remember, the volatility is your friend. You have to learn how to take advantage of it and not let it take advantage of you. But drop your comments down below. Let me know what you guys are doing during this time, during these dumps, to make sure that your mental health is good and that you're making smart trading decisions. That's all I got. Be blessed. BitBoy out.